In the following video series, we're going to take a look at how Acme Coffee Roasters is able to easily add and edit their integration flows to support their growing business. In this first example, we are in App Connect Designer, leveraging a flow previously set up to enable delivery via a business partner. With the booming expansion, the business partner, Gifts Inc., has alerted us that they can no longer support deliveries to both the East and West Coast. So today, I'm going to quickly onboard an additional business partner to facilitate delivery to the West Coast. This new business partner leverages Salesforce, so I'm going to have to set up a new connection to the Salesforce connector to quickly prepare my new flow. Before we dive in, I want to be sure I'm reoriented with the product, so I'm going to quickly navigate through the primary tabs. Getting started on my home page, I can see at the top all of my recently edited integrations to jump back in with. Beneath them are our primary actions, create an event-driven flow, create a flow for an API, import a flow, or new capability, to manage our API flows using IBM API Connect and IBM App Connect with our unified authoring experience. At the bottom, I can also access Toolkit for more advanced integration scenarios. Jumping to the top right, I can also see Help and Support visible in the top corner. Beside that are my user management settings available under my profile. Now, quickly navigating throughout the product, I see my dashboard with all of my in-progress flows, as well as a feature for AI-generated flows. AI-generated flows leverage natural language to be able to create a sample template for you to build with. As you can see here with my text, a new template is automatically generated for me to quickly leverage and open within Designer. In this instance, I'm going to continue exploring. So I jump to our catalog where I can take a look at all of our out-of-the-box connectors. The ones I'm already connected to are visible at the top. Next, I'll take a look at all of our out-of-the-box templates. And then I can quickly see logs and settings for additional support within my product experience. Jumping into Dashboard, I quickly open up my flow. Once it loads, I'm able to continue building on this flow experience by adding in our new business partner. I'm going to imitate what I see above by selecting the else if node, typing ship to state, and setting it equal to California for our West Coast deliveries. This is the end of the flow, so I'll also include an exit message. Next, I need to add in our connector. By selecting this plus icon, I can see a list of all our out-of-the-box connectors and can quickly select Salesforce and our new create orders function. I'm going to switch to advanced mode so that you can see the full list of fields here. And leveraging Mapping Assist, I'm able to use AI to auto-populate the mappings between each of these fields from Microsoft Dynamics into Salesforce. That saves me a ton of time. I also need to keep in mind a request we received from the business partner. They want us to append the name gift packages onto all of the orders that we send through them. I'm able to do that really simply here with Data Assist. First, I generate some sample data, then I copy it over and edit it to look like what I want, and quickly paste that across all of these, and then select transform to see a transformation formula generated. Perfect, no coding required. After a quick once over, I'm confident and ready to begin testing. I select Microsoft Dynamics, take a look at my sample data, ensure a fresh set has been generated, and then go ahead and try this flow. Perfect, looks like it was a success. Now there's nothing left for me to do but get started with my new flow. Hopefully in this process, you are able to see how easy it was to be able to add a new business partner into our integration flow, leveraging our no-code authoring tool, Designer.